just finished our water activity. Mama Ali and I got to explore and see some cute white fish. They're really adorable and shiny. Now we're kind of rinsed up, but we're gonna head over to a town nearby called Waimea to grab lunch. I'm always really hungry after water play, so I'm excited for lunch. Just woke up from a nap and we're heading over to the manta ray swimming. Got here a little early, so we're just waiting for the boat.
Hawaii is the land of jeeps. There's four here. I swear this is not a jeep dealership. There's another one there, and there's our jeep. There's so many chickens. Oh my gosh, chickens are in the trees.
Hawaiian chickens can fly. We just got back from the manta ray night snorkel. Wow, it was really quite an experience. The manta rays are gigantic. Our guide's name was Buddha, and he is a manta ray whisperer. At first I was doubtful, but he managed to let us see six different manta rays, and then one of them just loved our group and just stayed with us the entire time. From the moment I went into the water and got like attached to the flotation device, I saw manta rays nonstop. It was so cool. They came up really close, feels like they're this close to you. And there were moments where I was like kind of bracing myself because I felt like their wingtips were gonna touch me. They never did touch me, but it was really, really, really magical. Tomorrow is going to be really fun. We're going to be seeing a lot of greenery. We're going to the east side, which gets a little more rain, and it makes everything more lush and beautiful in a very different way. Yeah, so tomorrow's going to be a lot of like adventuring, the land exploration portion. Anyhow, it's not even 10 p.m. It's like 9:47 p.m. and I'm already like so tired, so I'm gonna wash up and go to sleep. Playing as we are wrapping up our packing, and I'm starting to feel the Loco Moco taking over with food coma. We've arrived at Waipio Valley and very luckily found parking after waiting for a while. So pretty, I see like a little town down there with a lake and little houses over there. It's very beautiful. We're stopping by a local eatery called Tex Drive-In. They're known for molasada, which is a Hawaiian donut. We got the Bavarian cream, which is the most popular, one with no filling and one with strawberry. Ooh, this is the Bavarian cream. This one doesn't have anything in it, and this is a strawberry. They're very generous with their filling. This is the Kalua shredded pork with cabbage and macaroni and rice. So pretty. Wow. Oh my goodness. Wow, the greenery. So beautiful. We're on a jungle tour. I'm trying to catch a melody. I'm trying to catch a melody. Like avatars would.
Way too long. Wake me up and take me home. Don't let go. The secret you've been keeping so long. Spending like a thousand hours, picking up flowers you laid out for me. Follow through unknown lands and valleys forever, trying to catch a melody. Spending like a million hours, picking up flowers you laid out for me. Follow through unknown lands and valleys forever, trying to catch a melody.
Without exaggeration, this is one of the most beautiful walks I have ever been on. So serene, so refreshing. I think it's 85 degrees, but it really feels like it's 75. You can feel the coolness just radiating from the trees. The trees here are kind of variations of plants I have seen before. Bamboo and ferns and I forget what they're called, but plants I've definitely seen at the plant store. But it's just a different variation and much more grand, so it's really cool to see it all in nature together. Oh, I just choked myself. Oh, get my safari hat back on. It's just so nice to have the sound of water next to you. So peaceful. And now we see some open sky. Now that we've treated ourselves by enjoying the little downhill walk, we have to climb a bunch of flight of stairs. There's Mama and Papa Lee. So, so beautiful. I feel it. It is most definitely 80 something now. I appreciate the shade that we had initially. We made it to the Akakaka Falls. There's only one Akaka. It smells super fruity here. Oh, these are so cute. It's good. 맛있어. It's very sweet.
Yeah, very good. That was soft, right?
We're now heading to the black sand beach in Punaulu. Whoa, the sand is just like black. This is very trippy. This place feels like Jurassic Park 2. Cool, we got to see the underground tunnel that was paved by lava. Kind of eerie inside, but also very chilling in a refreshing way. Now we trek on to where are we going? Oh. Kilauea Overlook. Whoa,
how did this tree grow like this? Like a picture frame.
Whoa. Wow, this is so grand.
Oh, there's people.
This is so funny. 맞아, 저기 사람에서 걸어오고 있어.
Wow, that's a long trail. I think it's like a 3-mile trail to walk all that.
It's so big. It's super grand.
Wow, 저기 햇빛이 쬐는 게 너무 예뻐. Wow.
Okay. Oh, it's kind of warm. Oh, it's actually pretty warm. Wow.
조심해, 조심해.
Okay, now you guys are in the steam. Enjoy the steam. All of your wishes will come true. It smells like steamed eggs. Oof.
Oh, oh,
oh.
It's amazing. 진짜 멋있다. 어.
The reason Mama Lee and I were dying of laughter on the boat earlier is because we were fully expecting that they would have full-size life vests, because all other water activities I've done in Hawaii have provided those like puffy foam full-size life vests. Every time we asked for the life vest, they said, yeah, we have life vests, we'll give it to you, always in future tense. So we're like, okay, I guess they'll give it to us. Once we're on the boat, they don't give it to us. We sail out for 20 minutes, we're about to go into the water, and they're still not giving us the life vest. We asked one more time, are we gonna get the life vest? And he's like, yeah, I can give you a life vest. As he says that, he pulls out a small neon yellow inflatable tube life vest and starts like puffing up with his mouth, and that's when the light bulb went off. Oh, this is why they avoided saying they have life vests, because they only want to provide it for people who really need it. We were just like cracking up so much when we saw the guy like, oh, this girl really, really wants a life vest. He didn't offer it to anyone else, and then another party asked for it, and then you could see the fear in his eyes. He's like, I hope more people don't request it, because otherwise I'm gonna like pass out on this boat.